ओम शांति शांति शांति, ओम पीस पीस पीस। How beautiful our life is when there is no thought. When there is not too much of planning. And you have acceptance to whatever comes. As a neurologist, I learned that memory is stored in the brain, and the remote memory, the old memory, goes quite deep, and the short memory is more superficial. And as people have dementia or Alzheimer's disease, they have more problem with the short-term memory, the recent things which they have learned. And the old memory, childhood memories, they can stay longer. I remember a lady I was treating for dementia for more than 10 years. And at the end, the only thing she could remember, or I should say was able to sing or speak, was a song she learned probably at the age of 10. She could not remember her husband, about herself. Everything was erased. And when her husband used to bring her, she was always smiling. and it was the husband who was the most sad person. Because he remembered all the story with that lady. But she has no clue. So what this story tells you, this story is our own story. A normal human being have 60 to 80,000 thoughts in a day. But how many thoughts we remember? And how many thoughts trouble us? So, you ask anyone whether you want to have dementia or Alzheimer's, or if your relative has an Alzheimer's or dementia, someone, everyone will say it's a pathetic situation and you never want this to happen to you. But have a look again. With 60 to 80,000 thoughts in a day, we remember maybe 6 or 8, and they trouble us so much that we have no time to rest. Let's say we get a dementia in which all these thoughts disappear. And just a blank void is left. How beautiful it would be. Is this not all of us desire, wants to reach, pray for it? You pick up any religion of the world, it's all about getting rid of the mind. Mind is a bundle of thoughts. Thoughts of fear, death, future, past. What are these things? They are all thoughts. Only thoughts bother us. And thoughts bother us because we have a story. A story of an individual, and the story keeps going. Look, I am a doctor, and when I see patients, their story starts with a trauma at the age of 8, 10, 6. With all my compassion, I look and I feel sorry for that story. But who is carrying that story from the age of 10 and not leaving? You ask these patients and they would be happy if someone erases this memory of this story. And I come across a lot of people on a spiritual path and they always talk about their previous births. And if I can tell them, who can tell about their previous births? I think this birth story is more than enough to trouble us, isn't it? Why we want to know the stories of previous births? God is so kind to us that He has erased all the memory of previous births. Story of this birth is too much of burden. And we feel so proud when we can remember small details of anything. And we tell others that our memory is so sharp, like a razor's edge. I remember everything. Bhagwan Sri Ramana Maharshi used to say, to his simple devotees who could not even recite any mantra, that it is just a play of mind. You can remember whole Bhagavad Gita or any shastra or mantra, who cares? It's a function of your mind. You don't have to remember anything. How beautiful it would be if we are like an empty space without remembering anything. Then there'll be no prejudice against anything. We will accept whatever comes, because nothing to judge, nothing to compare, nothing to correlate. We treat everything as it comes. And this is the saintly life. This is the life of an empty mind. You don't judge, you don't compare. You always live in this moment. You don't plan to make friends, and you don't plan against people whom you think they are enemies. Even when you know the intentions of others, good or bad, you don't care. Because the person who cared about all those things has disappeared. The person who was always busy in listening to thoughts has disappeared. And how can you make this person disappear? By paying your attention all the time to the silence within, not to the mind. It looks so absurd, because you will argue that mind gives a lot of beautiful things. I think and I do and then I become. I have become a lawyer, an accountant, an engineer, a doctor, a multimillionaire. I have traveled, I have built a house, bought a car. This is a big myth. As Bhagwan puts it right, whatever has to happen will happen. How much you resist it not to happen. And whatever has not to happen, how much efforts you put, it is not going to happen. This simple truth, if you can make your own truth, you are free right now. All our struggle is to become something, to impress upon someone something. But when you know that if something has to happen, will happen, then you are already free. All our life we have been taught in school to remember, remember, remember. And we have to be like a parrot, remembering everything. Let's say you do something and you don't remember how beautiful it is. I'll tell you honestly, if you don't remember, you're always full of energy. Because you are not counting how much work you have done, how many good or bad deeds you have done. If you don't remember, then who will remember? Law of karma also applies when we do things with intention. Intention of good or intention of bad. But when you have no intention, you don't accumulate any karma. Your slate is always clean. So how to live like this? Like a clean slate, always fresh, always new, always innocent. When you pay attention to only one thing in your life, the silence within. No one can keep paying attention to silence within deliberately. It is so hard. Practice or sadhana is to recognize the silence within. And if you have recognized this even for a second, who would like to slip back into the mind? Who wants so much of noise and suffering? So the paying attention is to recognize this silence within and whole sadhana practice is to just recognize it. Tune yourself with that silence and then job is done. Then you can lead a sahaj life, a natural life, because now you know you are this pure awareness. It is always there. It is the mind which comes and goes. And sometimes mind might come really big on you. But when you know you are awareness, it can't move you. And when the mind goes away, again, you are in silence, deep silence. And when the mind comes, you have silence plus noise. Then you are always silence, silence plus noise or silence minus noise. Noise of the mind. But you are so adept to this silence that it never leaves you. I'll give you an example about 5-6 years back. My two sons were having a verbal fight and I had no clue what was happening. The younger one was saying, "Stop this noise, it's so irritating." And he was quiet and I couldn't hear any sound. And then they told me something which I have never heard before. The older one was playing something from some instrument, making a noise which was very irritating, but I could not hear it. And he said, "It's only until certain age kids can hear at that frequency." And that was a big eye-opening to me, that there are so many noises that we can't hear. Same is with the silence within. We all have that silence within, but we can't hear. Because our frequency is different from the silence within. We just have to make our frequency exactly the same as the silence within. we just have to do for 1 second. Once done, now you know, you have a knack of it. And you can never lose it. So the whole sadhana and practice it to be in that silence, to recognize that silence, and then abidance in silence will happen automatically. Because who wants to leave the shade and go back into the scorching sun of noise, of mind, of suffering, of ego self? This fine tuning is all what we are doing in satsang. Satsang is a place where there is nothing but absolute truth. Pure silence. Your own silence. Your own silence is everyone's silence. Your awareness is everyone's awareness. But you need to understand this game. Each person has to discover their own silence. Because you are having your own individualistic dream. To break that dream, you have to transcend from the dream to the silence. It is as if you are dreaming at night and there are so many people in that dream. And you want to break that dream. And you will think, but what will happen with the other people in the dream? They are still suffering. They are killing each other. Can I make them awake? Before I break my dream, can I break their dream? If you tell this to anyone, people will think you are a moron. You are an idiot. But that's what the whole world is doing. You ask anyone and they will think a person on a spiritual path is selfish. It is more important to help people, real people, suffering in the world, give them food, shelter. They have been assaulted. They have been under racial discrimination or whatever. There are thousands and thousands and thousands of issues in this world. Let's do some good work rather than sitting in silence and going into awareness and doing all this crap. It is exactly in your dream if you are trying to help people but don't want to break the dream. There is no difference except one. The dream in sleep gets broken on its own when you wake up in morning. And this dream, waking dream, looks like a continuity. Although it breaks, and we pick up from where it has broken. Because this dream ends, waking dream ends when we go into sleep. And then the dream sleep also ends and we go into deep sleep. And then this waking dream comes back again. And we think we have picked up where we left when we went to bed. This is the illusion. This is the Maya. And Maya can't leave you so easily unless you are 100% convinced that whatever is happening in the dream. And you want to break this dream by not touching the mind, not touching the thoughts, staying in your own silence, pure awareness. But who can convince you? Everyone and anyone who has broken their dream, broken their illusion, transcended themselves, and is staying in their own joy and bliss, always happy, always contented, always speaking the truth, always fresh, fearless and humble, but firm. All of those people from ancient times to present time, when you see their face, when you listen to them, read what they have said, is to convince you that this is a dream and you can break this dream. And the day you are 100% convinced, it takes no time to break this dream. It's only your interest in this dream, objects, images, which leads it to continue. It is like a movie on the screen. It will continue till you are watching it with interest. The moment you have lost complete interest in the movie, you are not interested in any character of this movie, anything in this movie, the movie will end immediately. So if the movie is still going and we are crying, it is because of self-sabotage. We still have some interest in movie in some part of this movie. It could be the good part of the movie. It could be the most sattvic, most pure part of the movie. But there must be something in the movie which we can't leave. There is a beautiful story about Ramakrishna Paramhans, which was an Indian sage. He reached to that highest level, but the only thing left was the Kali idol. He was worshipping Kali all his life, the Indian goddess. So there was a duality still. And a saint came who explained him very clearly this thing. Totapuri. And the last illusion disappeared. And Ramakrishna Paramhans got into non-duality. So you can start as an idol worshipper. Or you can have an Ishtadevta or a god you worship. But then you have to come to this awareness only. You have to leave that. That's why I always say, path of non-duality, Advaita, is the direct path. You have not taken any support from anything. It looks difficult, but it's so direct. path of a mature spiritual seeker, path of an advanced sadhaka, path of instantaneous realization. You are standing on your own support of awareness in this void. You are nothing but just pure seeing. No form. If you have no form, no relations, no God, no rituals. If you have no form, nothing to be done. You're not waiting for something to be done or something to happen. Formless can't be dependent on form. Formless is always free. You watch your body as you watch others' body. Because you are free now, you don't mind if the body stays or body goes away. You are already detached. You are already free. It was a mere illusion that you thought you were the body. And the moment it is your own experiential knowledge that you are not the body, and the mind becomes completely empty. And goes in its own restful state. Because you have no interest in a story, all the story disappears. From the past, from the future, and from present. You walk like no one. You behave like no one. You don't claim for anything. You don't remember anything. You don't judge anything. You are like a child. Whatever comes, you will explore like it's all new, with inquisitiveness, without thoughts, without mind, without anything to compare. All your life will be intuitive, governed by your heart, not the mind. Governed by the love, not by cunningness. And you have 100% faith in the power of God. For you, everything is a blessing. Whether good happens with the body mind or bad happens to the body mind, you don't care, because now you know you are not any body mind. and you also don't care about other body minds, how they react, act against this body mind, because you know it's all part of the dream. You alone exist, nothing else. You are that awareness, blemishless, untainted, uninvolved, always happy, pure. You have no guru. You have no one. You can't worship anyone except yourself. Wherever you went, whatever you practiced, this self, this God, this guru, within you only did it for you. No one else. Because there is no one else. So all the credit goes to you. It is your own glory. All prayers to you. All respect to you. There is no pride in it. Bhagwan always said, God, Guru and Self is the same, no difference. Because consciousness is always one, it's singular, it's not dualistic. And you are that. Remember and live like a king. You are the ruler of whole universe, whole cosmos. You stand alone on your own support. Come out of this condensed consciousness of ego, selfishness, cunningness, greediness, meanness. You were never that. By mistake, you thought you are this thief, body mind. You were always a king. It's a case of mistaken identity. Hold your ears and say sorry to your own self. That by mistake, I thought I am this body mind. Please forgive me. You were playing this game from the worst place, most filthy place, most lowliest place in the world. Worse than any creature. Full of the filth of ego. Garbage of thoughts of mind. But now you know you are pure awareness. Who cares what the mind says or what it carries? In this pure awareness, in the fire of the self-effulgence, it burns the mind, burns all thoughts, desires, your personality, your story, and all the relations and everything attached to it, leaving you in your naked truth, pure awareness. If you see Bhagwan's photo, you only see two eyes, nothing else. Those eyes are always looking into your awareness, not your body mind. Innocent, pure eyes. They penetrate deep through your body mind complex into your awareness. Let what happened to this body mind. Don't be its advocate. Let people criticize this body mind. Who cares? As pure awareness, no one can increase or decrease your glory. You stand on your own support. Always free, unbound. Throughout the day, whatever this body mind does, you are unconcerned. Nothing is right or wrong for you because you are not involved. You stay as a pure witness. No amount of money can make you happy, and no amount of loss of money will make you unhappy. Good health is not making you happy, or a dreaded disease is making you unhappy. Good relations with friends and family is not making you happy, and criticism and separation is not making you unhappy. As awareness, you are always the same, unattached, uninterested, happy in its own joy, joy of this awareness, with unconditional love for everything, because everything is you only. As pure awareness. All the images are fake as your own image. Then who cares about other images when you're not caring even about your own image, image of the body mind through which you interact in this world? You become instantaneously free. Just 100% conviction is needed. You have no interest in the body mind. Body mind was never interested in you. These were the tools given to us. And we became so much involved that consciousness became condensed to this body mind. But now you know that you are pure awareness. Live like pure awareness. Live in your own splendor. Live like a king. Don't beg for things. Nothing in this world can give you any joy. You are joy. You don't know any sorrow. You don't need any company. You don't know any boredom. You don't know any entertainment. All our life, we were doing all the wrong things to entertain this filthy body and mind. What a pity on us. Doing for a body which is soon to leave us. What a shame. When you look back, what we did until now, it looks so shameful. But at least now we know that we are not born to serve this body mind. We are here to live like what we are, pure awareness. This pure awareness is taking care of billions of beings, birds, animals, plants, rocks, sun, moon, earth, everything. Then who cares of one body mind? Same awareness will take care of that as well. All the life insurance, income protection, shares, mortgage, who cares? For whom? For that fake body mind which we are not. For all the relations coming out of the same body mind which we are not. Then why to worry? Worry for whom? For the insentient body? The moment you leave this body, it will be dead. Stay like pure awareness all the time, in solitude or in company of people. Always. Don't wear the mask of personality again. Even if someone comes and wants to kill you, don't leave your true identity. Because no one can kill you. You are unborn. No death to you. You are not interested in this body mind, whether it stays or goes. You are free now. And I assure you, when you don't care about the body mind, this will be taken care of by the divine power, which is taking care of everything and that divine power will take care of this body mind better than you as the ego. Give up this role. Stop your acting. Come back as what you are, pure awareness. Don't pick up any concepts. I'm not giving you any new concepts. You just stay as you are, in your own silence. You stay as awareness, you don't have to do anything. Shanti, Shanti.